name is Mr. Sandesh Pare. I am currently working as an assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science and Engineering at Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. So in this session, we are going to introduce you to the Python. So before going to start the session, we just want to recheck what is the outcome of this session. At the end of this video, you will be introduced to the Python programming language. So let's start to the introduction to the Python programming language. Okay, so we'll start from the history. Okay, as you know, Python was introduced, okay, in the 90s, okay, by the Guido van Rossum. Okay, it is invented in the Netherlands. Okay, some of the programmers are not aware about this thing, but yeah, it's shocking that it was available from the 90s and it was there, but it is silently at the back end. Okay, it was not in the boom. Okay, when Java and other programming languages are used so frequently by the MNCs, but Python is there, but it was not focused by the anybody. Okay, so it was conceived in the late 90s. Okay, and its implementation actually was started in the December 1989. Okay, and lot of people get cured about why the name is Python. Okay, as all of them think about the it is one of the most dangerous snake, that but what that is not the history of the Python programming language. Actually, Guido van Rossum is a fan of particular famous TV show which was in the Netherlands, and Monty Python's Flying Circus was the name of that TV show, and he was the big fan of that. So based on that name, he named his programming language as the Python. Okay, and one thing about I just want to tell you, the Python programming language is the open source programming language, and from the beginning also. Okay, so the code is available to everyone. Okay, anybody can make the changes and release his own versions, okay, according to whatever he has. Okay, so this was the history about the Python programming language, and let's see what are we going to learn in the upcoming videos of this Python programming languages. Okay, first we will start with the very basics, that is variables, and what are the data types, okay, and which are the operators, and how to get the user inputs and all that. Okay, and for all these things, okay, there are some ready-made techniques are there, and we have to use them to implement our program. And obviously, when we use certain ready-made functions, then there is basically a syntax to use it, and we have to follow them. Okay, then for that we are going to learn the syntax of the different things, and after that there is various concepts, okay, which are used in the Python. Okay, some of them are came from the hierarchically, that is from the other programming languages, and some of the concepts are introduced in the Python. Okay, so these concepts are we are going to learn, okay, in the upcoming videos. So first question is our mind, that what is Python, okay, and why it is growing so fast. Okay, so reason behind this is that first of all we have to think about this is the fastest growing programming languages means what, why we call it is the fastest growing programming language. Okay, because the number of developers, okay, in the MNCs are currently using it are going increasing rapidly. Okay, most of the developers are switching to the Python programming languages for their convenience. Okay, there are various reasons for that. Okay, we'll discuss it later. And second thing is that the number of libraries included in it. Okay, because as I said earlier, that it is the open source programming languages. Okay, so anybody can make any changes, and anybody can release its own version, and it may be helpful for the lot of communities. Okay, And that's why the number of libraries are included in these programming languages are increasing day by day. Okay, so this is also one of the reason. And third is the number of companies which are using it. Okay, so lot of MNCs are using this programming language in the nowadays. And which are those companies, that also we are going to see in the next in the next slides. And the number of areas, okay, it is one of the big issue, that okay, number of areas in which it is applied. Okay, there are lot of upcoming trends, otherwise we can say the modules, okay, in the market, and Python is supporting for all of them. Okay, just like artificial intelligence, okay, machine learning, okay, and data science. Okay, these are the things which are in the boom currently now in market. Okay, and Python is supporting to all of them. Okay, that is one of the major reason behind making it the fastest growing programming language. Okay, and because of these reasons, okay, generally what is the term assigned to this Python programming languages is that it is the general programming purpose programming language. Okay, so let's focus on the features of the Python. Okay, as you can see, it is a high level language that is a application developer is dealing with this. Okay, so it is at the high end, so that's why it is called as the high level language. And yes, it is the developer friendly language because it is very very easy to code in the Python programming languages, because lot of syntaxes and lot of stuff which are unnecessarily making any burden to the programmers, okay, that all are removed here. Okay, which are they, we are going to focus in the next sessions, but I'm just telling you that lot of things are removed which are creating any chaos for the programmers. Okay, and it is called as the dynamic, okay, because any part of the code, okay, you can write in the other programming languages also, okay, just like the C and C++. Okay, any part of code, if you want to fetch feel that it is difficult to write in Python, then you can write into the C and C++ like that, and it supports totally. Okay, that's why it is called as the dynamic one. Okay, and as I said earlier, that this is the free open source language. And yes, next is interpreted. As we know, earlier programming languages are compiled and interpreted. Okay, we first have to compile that file and then we are going to interpret that. Okay, but that compilation is also removed here. Okay, whatever your file, higher level end file, is get interpreted directly. Okay, and it supports all the object oriented concepts. Okay, just like your abstraction, encapsulation, inheritance, polymorphism, class, object, all these concepts are supported by the programming Python programming language. Okay, so this is also one of the best feature of this Python. And yes, it is supporting the GUI programming. Okay, so any graphics related program, if you want to do, then you can do using the Python programming language. And it is the extensible one. Okay, as I said earlier, if you want to add any libraries to this one, then you can add that. Already it is having very large and standard library. Okay, and it includes all the things that is regular expression, unit testing, and web browsers like that. Okay, so there is all but if you want to give any input, then it is acceptable. Okay, and just like the Java, it is also the portable, that you can execute and it can work totally on the any platform because of its virtual machine, just like JVM. Okay, here the Python virtual machine is there. Okay, and that's why the it is totally portable. Okay, and dynamically typed language, because when you use certain variables, okay, you did not to be mention its type there. Okay, it will, based on the values which you assign to that variables, according to it, it will automatically get understood that what should be the data type of that particular variable. Okay, it will not make mandatory for the programmers to write manually there. Okay, so there is one question for you guys, that why Python is called as the general purpose programming language. Think and answer. Python is the very fastest growing programming language, as we know. Okay, as we discussed earlier, because the number of developers which are currently using it is going very rapidly, okay, and the number of libraries which are included in it, okay, and day by day it is going to increase, and it is making so much facilities to the users of the Python programming languages, and that's why it is also growing so fast, and that's why it is called as a general purpose programming language. And the number of companies, yes, lot of MNCs, okay, and the standard MNCs which are in the boom are using this one, and the number of areas just like artificial intelligence and data science, okay, and machine learning are using this one, so that's why it is called as the general purpose programming language. See, as I told you earlier, that various fields, okay, which are using this, that system programming, okay, internet scripting is also there, okay, graphical, gaming, database programming, machine learning, okay, all these fields are using the Python programming language, and that's why it is being so popular day by day, okay. And as I told you earlier, that lot of MNCs are also using this Python programming languages, okay, one of the biggest MNCs like the Google, Yahoo, okay, so it is a tag mark, okay, because if Google and Yahoo are using your programming languages, then it means it is the tag mark that it is the best one, okay. And Intel, Cisco, HP, Seagate, okay, Uber, and your Instagram, YouTube, okay, image sharing services and video sharing services are also using this one. And one more tag mark is that scientist at NASA is also using the Python programming languages for their research work, okay, so it itself says enough about these programming languages, I think, okay. So there are different flavors of the Python which is available in the market, that is 1.x, 2.x and 3.x, okay. But I recommend the particular IDE for the PyCharm is the PyCharm, okay, you use it, it is so convenient, okay. So these are some references I used to make this video. Thank you.